Hello everyone, I'm Surya here, back again with one new video. So it should not be back again, so it should be I'm here with a video. So okay, so let's get started. So I'm here at Phet Simulator, if I'm correct, it's Phet Simulator. Oops. So what does this do? It's technically where all, you know, the, you know, it's like a simulation of where, like, of where science happens, you know. Get the idea? Like this. It's like, today I'm gonna have fun with the gravity. I'm gonna explain you how gravity works, what happens if there's no gravity, you know, all the basics of science. So, how does gravity work? We have a skater here, right here. Okay, you can see it. Yeah, we have a skater right here. We also have to create our own ramp. So yeah, that's a good thing, because if we use a built-in ramp, yeah, we all are dead, bro. Like, we all are like, yeah, done. So I'm gonna have the speed. It's right here. So okay, let's start with no friction, earth gravity, and a mass of 60 kgs. 60 kgs is a bit too much. My weight is 50 or 45. So I'm gonna decrease it to 45 should be nice. Okay, so let's put the skater at the tip of it. Now, okay, hold up. I'm gonna pause this first. I gotta explain to you what happens here. So as the skater comes from here to here, okay, why am I even pausing? You guys have to start. Okay, so the skater is going from here at the edge. Now coming back at the edge again. Coming back to the edge. You can even see the speed. It's 10. It's 10 miles per hour. Okay, wait, it's 10 meters. Oh my god, miles. It's 10 meters per second. So now this is no friction. Now I'm gonna add one. Gonna add very little friction. Now we're gonna see what happens to the skater. You see, I put at the tip, but it's slowly coming, slowly making its way down, even less. Now it's still very slow. There's very less friction. There you go. It's still going. Yo, can you just finish faster? Okay, so this is it. Lots. I have a lot of friction right now. Not forget it. So, but this is just in Earth gravity. So, what would happen if we have it in Jupiter gravity? You know how cool that would be? Oh my god, it's gonna be a lot. It's Jupiter. You know how Jupiter is? Jupiter is like the biggest planet in the solar system. Okay, let's take a look at how. In Earth, you see how slow she fell. Look at the speedometer. 11 meters per second. Now, let's look at Jupiter. She went to 20 meters per second. Okay, that is actually fast, okay? 20 meters per second is pretty fast. So let's put, okay, it's not equal. Okay, hold up. This is why we have this. We have some grids in the middle, right? Okay, there you go. So now let's take a look at Jupiter's gravity with half of the friction. The mass will be still the same because I'm a very lucky boy. Okay, so let's put it. Look at, she went to 15 miles per second over here. At the middle. Okay, hold up. Oh, wait, now I have friction. Okay, hold up. Okay, I'm gonna pause it right here. Place her at the edge. Put, I forgot, oh my god. Put no friction. Now let's see when she comes to the limit. I'll put it slow. She is going at 16 meters per second. If you round up, it's 17. Okay, 17 is pretty fast. This is no fiction. Let's add a little bit. Half of it, not, yeah, so yeah. Then, she's slowly making her way down. See, when you, okay, for example, let's go over here. If she's over here, right, so she'll probably come up to over here, like maximum over here. Shall we check it out? See, I told you. She will come maximum because since there's friction is technically something like, for example, friction is something that's keeping you up. For example, if you're walking, you know the rubbers under your shoe? That is keeping you upright. You know, upright? Yeah, that is what is keeping you upright. That it like doesn't make you slip. See, for example, if there's no friction, I drop her right here. I tell you what, she'll be going until here. See? Can you see? She's going to the very edge. This is no friction. So if you put half of it, she'll come up to here. Okay, never mind. She came even slower. See, that is what friction does to our life. Friction is very important in our life because if friction doesn't exist, we'll all be sleeping. Cars will go, you know, cars will just like crash into each other. Our cars will just crash into each other. We'll be falling every single time. We can't even like, you know, do basics of what we can. See, if we don't have friction, for example, if you want to wash your face, your hands will just slip since there's no friction. That is what happens when there's no friction. So, what are the impacts of friction? Friction. I mean, I already just told you, so that question is pointless. So, friction is very important, as you guys can see. So, even Earth has friction. So, I'm going to change it back to Earth. Friction. I'm going to place... Oh my God, this guy. I'm going to place her at the very edge. If there's no friction, I don't know what happens to the planet. So, yeah. But, I mean, it's beyond the laws of physics, so it can never happen. You know? Okay, so let's play. She will go up to here. Here or here? One or two. Type it in the comments. One, this line or this line. This line or this line. Between here and where? Let's play it. See, she's going half. She's going by half. She went up to here. Now she'll go up to here. See, she goes up to half. That because there's friction. If there's no friction, she'll be going there infinitely. Let's place her right here. She'll be up here for infinite. Let's place the grid. Okay, we have it up to here. She'll be here. She'll be over here. That is what will happen if there's no friction. Oh, maybe, never mind. She increases her speed because she's gaining speed and losing speed. Let's look at the energy bar. See, when she comes over here, she has maximum. She has maximum kinetic energy. She has very less potential energy. Thermal energy, I don't even know why thermal energy exists. And what is this? Total, yes, this is total. So it's kinetic and potential energy combined. Is it total? I'm pretty sure it's total. Okay, next. What if we increase mass? Increase mass. Her kinetic energy goes nuts. Her potential energy also goes nuts. What if we have tons of friction and go up to here? She has a lot of thermal energy. Okay, I need this to be somewhere else. Hold on. Oh wait, oh okay, I see why. Let's place her right here. See, she's going not even half. Look at the thermal and oh my God, this thing is nuts. See, her potential energy still increases because she can move. She has the potential to move, but she isn't. So, what if you keep her over here? No. Oh my god, okay. Hold on. We keep her right here at the very tip. We have no friction, no one bar of gravity, very less mass. Let's play. Look at how slow she goes. Look at how slow she goes. She just went off the thing. What? Because there's barely any gravity to keep her on the ground. So. Look. She just speeds up here. She just falls down. So, what if I keep it over here? What if I keep it at you? Will she still go off the thing? Will she still go off this ramp? Let's find out. She barely did. So maybe it was my fault. I put the ramp so high. So of course he falls. See, this is what happens. You move super slow. What if you have a lot of gravity? Okay, maybe not that much gravity, but Earth gravity. She's going nuts. Okay, let's see. See, in Earth gravity, you just keep on going. Unless we add friction. It's very less friction, okay? I swear to God. There you go, she's slowing down. See, friction does a lot of good things and bad things. Gravity is very important in our lives. See, if we don't have gravity, we are all doomed. Because gravity keeps our atmosphere. It keeps our atmosphere in the sky. Mass also plays a very, very important role in us. See, if you have zero mass, I don't even think you exist. I'm not even sure if you exist, in fact. So, mass, gravity, friction is very important in life. Please don't forget that. And thank you for watching this video. Bye-bye.